Hello everyone, today we are going to see our next point. Next point in the sense, already we have seen this graphically. Okay, so what is the name of our point C? Conditions for solubility or consistency. Okay, and here the system of equations. Two equations are given, a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Two equations are given. Okay, and here we have to check the conditions of solubility. Okay, so already we have seen there are three ratios we need to use for this. Okay, so what are the three ratios? A1 by B2, A1 by B2, B1 by B2, and C1 by C2. Three ratios, with the help of these three ratios we are going to decide the conditions of solubility. Okay, so first we are going to see that is A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Okay, means there are two equations. Okay, two equations, each equation will show a line in the Cartesian plane. Okay, so when A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, there is a unique solution. What you will get? Unique solution. This is first consistent and say unique solution. Unique solution means you will get the solution, exact one solution you will get, because the both the lines will intersect to each other. Okay, so this is we are thinking about Cartesian plane. We are thinking about Cartesian plane. Okay, so A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, that time this is consistent and you will get the unique solution. Okay, so line represents by equation. If suppose I will say this is equation 1 and this is equation 2, so lines represented by equation 1 and 2 will intersect at one point. Okay, we can say will intersect at one point, or we can say are not parallel. Okay, are not parallel means what? They will intersect. Okay, so here we can say lines represented by equation 1 and 2 are not parallel. Okay, not parallel means they will intersect at one point. Suppose this is that Cartesian plane and lines this is and this is. So definitely they are going to intersect at a unique point. So in such type of condition, when A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, that time this equation, we can say this is a consistent equation and there is a unique solution for this. Okay, now second thing we are going to see, that is when A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, is equal to C1 by C2, means all the three ratios are equal. So when all the three ratios are equal, that time what we can say? Think little. When all the three ratios are equal, that time what we can say? Line represented by equation first and second are consistent. Okay, are consistent and coincident lines. Okay, coincident lines. What is mean by coincident lines? Coincident line is there are two equations. Each equation will show a line. Suppose this equation, this is for equation first, then second equation also will show the same line on the same line. Understood? So the line, this condition is known as coincident lines. Understood? So here this is also consistent and coincident lines. Okay, coincident line means what we can say? Infinitely many solutions. You will get here many solutions. Okay, so here we said lines represented by equation first and second with coincident lines. Lines are coincident, that's why there are infinitely many solutions. Understood? Two conditions we have seen, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, consistent, unique solution. when a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, that time consistent but infinitely many solutions. Okay, now third one we are going to see, that is when a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C2. That time what we can say? Line represented by equation first and second are parallel and non-consistent. Okay. So here we can say parallel line simulated. Okay. So what we can say? Inconsistent. This is not consistent. Inconsistent. Parallel lines. Parallel lines, how we can represent parallel lines? Okay, suppose this is that Cartesian plane, so one line will be like this, second will be like this, means they will not intersect. So how many solutions you will get here? Lines represented by equation first and second are parallel and non-coincident. Okay, so parallel line is what we can say, this is inconsistent and they are parallel lines. Okay, here we said consistent unique solution, consistent infinitely many solutions. Okay, and in third condition, when a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, these two ratios are equal but not equal to c1 by c2, that time this is inconsistent and lines are parallel. Okay, lines are parallel. Okay, so this is conditions for solubility. We are going to solve examples depend on this. Getting everybody? Once again, see two equations we have taken simultaneously. Linear equations a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. The ratios we have taken a1 and a2, a1 divided by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2, where two ratios are not equal, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Okay, that time what we can say, this is consistent with unique solution. Okay, so line represented by equation first and second are not parallel means they will intersect. Okay, second, when a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2 is not e- sorry a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, that time what we can see, this is also consistent coincident line. Coincident means lines means both the lines will show same position in the Cartesian plane. Okay, so infinitely many solutions, so there you will get many solutions. Understood? Lines represented by equation first and second will be coincident lines. Okay, then third one, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2, that time inconsistent but lines are parallel. This is inconsistent and lines are parallel. So these are three conditions. We are going to see examples depend on this. Okay, now we are going to see examples which are depend on the conditions for solubility. Okay, see here, first question is, in each of the following system of equations determine the system has a unique solution, no solution or infinitely many solutions. In case there is a unique solution, find it. Okay, if you we will get unique solution, then we need to find it. Okay, so here two equations are given, 2x plus 3y is equal to 7 and 6x plus 5y is equal to 11. Two equations are given and now according to the ratio just now we have seen, as per that we are going to find out here ratios. Okay, so here this is a1, b1 and c1. Okay, a1, b1 and c1, a2, b2 and c2. Okay, so suppose I want to find out here a1 upon a2. What is a1 upon a2? 2 by 6, that is 1 by 3. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 1 by 3. Okay, now b1 by b2 is equal to 3 upon 5. Okay, 3 upon 5 will remain as it is. If you will observe here, first condition, a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 are not same. A1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, is not equal to b1 by b2, because 1 by 3 and 3 by 5 is completely different. Okay, so here we can say a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2.
from this we got a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. So we can say here, what we can say here? We can say the given system of equation has unique solution. The given system of equations has unique solution. Okay, why unique solution? Because these ratios, first two ratios are not equal, unique solution that we have decided. Okay. So now what is given? In case there is a unique solution, find it. Now we need to find out the unique solution. Okay. So we got the unique solution. Now we are going to use this both the formulas. We are going to find out the solutions. Okay. So I am taking both the equations here. 2x plus 3y is equal to 7 and 6x plus 5y is equal to 11. Okay. So here specifically they have not told us any method. So we can use any method. So I am saying this is first equation and this is second equation. Okay. So if I will multiply first equation by 3, then I will get 6x. So by making coefficients, so multiply equation first by 3 and subtract equation second from third. Okay, third equation you will get after multiplication. Okay, so here I multiply this equation by 3. So 3 2s are 6x plus 3 3s are 9y is equal to 7 3s are 21. Okay, minus the second equation we will subtract from that, 6x plus 5y is equal to 11. So here this plus will change into minus, this is minus. So plus 6x minus 6x gets cancelled. 9y minus 5y. 9 minus 5 will be 4y. 4y is equal to 10. Okay, 4y is equal to 10. So y is equal to 10 by 4. So we will get there 5 by 2. So y is equal to 2.5. Okay, so y is equal to, you will get 2.5, that is 5 by 2. Okay, now we will find out x is equal to, we can put this value, putting y is equal to 5 by 2 in equation first is 2x plus 3y is equal to 7. So equation 2x plus 3 into 1, y is 5 by 2 is equal to 7. 3 into 5 by 2 is equal to 7. So 2x plus 5 is 15, 15 by 2 is equal to 7. So 2x is equal to 7 minus 15 by 2. 2x is equal to 7 minus 15 by 2. So 2x is equal to 7 is a 14. 14 minus 15 will be minus 1 by 2. Okay. See, this x is equal to minus 1 by 2. This is multiplication. There will be division. So division is multiply with reciprocal. So 1 by 2. So x is equal to minus 1 by 4. Okay. X is equal to minus 1 by 4. Okay. So see carefully everyone. Once again, see what is given. Two equations are given. We have to find out the ratios a1 by a2, b1 by b2. First, two ratios are required. If both the ratios are equal, then we need to think about the third. Okay, third ratio. So a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 is not equal. If a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 are unequal, that then there is a unique solution. Okay, if unique solution they have told us, find the solutions. So we have taken their equations. You can use any method. By substitution also we can solve, by making coefficient also we can solve, or by cross multiplication. All the three methods we have seen. Now I have done this is by making coefficients. So here we have multiplied by 3. So y is equal to 5 by 2. Put this value in any one equation, you will get x is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay. Okay, see here, second example is given. Again, two equations are given. 6x plus 5y is equal to 11. And second equation, 9x plus 15 by 2y is equal to 21. Okay, so now a1 by a2, I am going to find out here a1 upon a2 is 6 upon 9. 6 upon 9 is 3 to the 6, 3 3 is a 9. So 2 by 3. Okay. A1 by A2 over, now B1 by B2 is equal to B1 b1 upon b2. b1 is 5 upon 15 by 2. Okay, 5 divided by 15 by 2 is what you can get here. You can write this 5 divided by 15 by 2 is you can multiply by 2 by 15. Okay, so you will get further 5 to the 10 upon 15. So you will get 5 to the upon 3. Okay, so 2 by 3, 2 by 3. So a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by 2. First we got. Now we will think about c1 by c2. C1 by C2, what is C1? 11. Okay, so it will come in the LHS, that time we get minus 11. Okay, and here minus 21. So minus minus will be cancelled. So we will get 11 by 20. Okay, so this is already in its lowest form. Okay, so what we can say from this, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2. What we can say, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. Okay, so what we can say from this result, we have seen third one. Okay, so what is your answer? Can you tell me? What is your answer? System of equation has no solution. Why no solutions? It is inconsistent. Okay, why? It is inconsistent. Inconsistent and no solution. Why no solution? Can you tell me? Why no solutions? Because we have seen third condition. What is in that? Lines are parallel. Okay, in the Cartesian plane, lines will be parallel. If lines are parallel, they will not intersect. If they will not intersect, we will not get any solution. Understood? So there is no solution and inconsistent. Okay? Got it, everyone? Okay, so this is according to the question, if unique solution is there, then only we need to find out. This is not unique solution, no solution and inconsistent. Okay? Okay, see here our next third one problem is, equations are given minus 3x plus 4y is equal to 5 and 9 by 2x minus 6y plus 15 by 2 is equal to 0. Okay, so first we will bring in the proper form. So this equation I am taking here, minus 3x plus 4y plus 5 into this side, that is minus 5 is equal to 0. Second equation, this is I am taking first one. Second equation is minus 9 by 2x minus 6y minus 15 by 2 is equal to 0. Two equations are there. Okay, so this is second equation. Okay, now what we can say here, we need to find out ratios. So first we will think about a1 by a2. a1 by a2 is equal to minus 3 upon 9 by 2. Minus 3 upon 9 by 2. So what we can say for this, minus 3 multiplied by 2 upon 9. Minus 3 multiplied by 2 upon 9, that is minus 6. Minus 6 by 9. So 3 to the 6, 3 3 is a 9. So minus 2 by 3. Okay. So a1 by a2 is minus 2 by 3. Now we will think about b1 by b2. B1 by b2. What is b1? B1 is 4. 4 upon minus 6. 4 upon minus 6 will be 2 upon 3. Minus 2 upon 2 upon 3. We can say minus 2 by 3. Okay. 2 upon minus 3 or minus 2 by 3. Same. So a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by 3. A1 by a2 is equal to b1 by 3. In this case, we need to find out third one ratio also. So third one ratio is c1 by C2. What is C1? C1 is minus 5. Minus 5 divided by 15 by 2. So minus 5 multiplied by 2 upon 15. Okay. So minus 10 by 15. So minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 by 3. Here also minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 by 3. Third one ratio is also minus 2 by 3. So what we can see here, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. All the three ratios are equal. Okay, so from this we can say there are infinitely many solutions. When all the three ratios are same, that time what we can say is consistent. This is consistent, having infinitely many solutions. Infinitely many solutions. Because ratios are equal. Understood? So there are infinitely many solutions. Okay, so in this case you will get all the three lines, all the both the lines, two lines for this equations, they will coincide. okay. So there are infinitely many solutions. So today we have seen conditions for solubility. Okay, how to decide there is a solution, no solution, or infinitely many solutions. Each type of one example we have seen. Understood? So see carefully, solve all the examples once again. Okay, this is very important point. Already some reference we have seen in the second chapter also. So see carefully, solve same problems. NCERT textbooks, from NCERT table also you need to complete exercises. Okay, and solve the worksheet which is given on this. Okay, thank you.